Wait a sec. Getting ahead of myself here. Gotta let Instagram know that I'm live. Okay. Bumper card. Hey, long time no see. How you doing? All right. This is gonna be a big one. So we gotta pull the camera up here. All the way up. Doing pretty good. Too bad. Oh, let's go a little further. You'll notice I'm wearing long sleeves, which I rarely ever do. It's because I actually got a tattoo, and it's still healing, and I'm trying to avoid rubbing it on directly on shit too much right now. And also realize that I might have kind of fucked up by using my my Huon to do some coloring the other day. They were like, keep it out of the sunlight. So I've been doing that, but never considered not leaning against a screen while working. So I'm like trying to make up for that a bit today. But otherwise, I'm pretty good. I'm not doing too bad. I only just watched Cowboy Bebop for the first time a week or so ago, actually. My original plan was I was going to do this on the stream just past Tuesday. But then I ended up doing Edgerunners because I couldn't do Edgerunners the week before because I wasn't feeling well. It was a whole thing. I wanted to do this one because if I'm happy with the way it turns out, I'm going to get it printed for Fan Expo. The first con of the year is coming up next month. So I decided to fast track it and do a bonus stream this weekend to get to it. I did, in fact, bring out the full. We have five characters to deal with here, so this is a big deal. And let's get into it. I got kind of an idea of what I'm doing. It might evolve a little bit as it goes, but we'll see. I have drawn Faye once before as part of the character design challenge, but at that point I had never watched it, so Faye will be included. But it won't just be Faye. And how are you doing, Billy? Thank you. liking this pose. I kind of think I need to draw it a little higher up on the page. I'm going to start fresh before I go too far, and we'll just flip it right around. I haven't seen the Cowboy Bebop movie yet, though. That wasn't on Netflix, unfortunately, so I haven't gotten to that one yet. But when the show was done, I was eager to watch it. And I will give the live-action one a shot. I've heard some say it's terrible. I've heard some say it's pretty decent. Or at the very least, one of the better live-action anime adaptions. I actually watched Plane last night in the theater, which I hadn't even heard of before. I just kind of was hanging out with some friends and decided to go see a movie last minute. And the girl that plays Faye in the live-action Netflix show was actually in it. Plane was not bad. It's, by modern standards, it's what would typically be a Netflix movie. I'm kind of surprised it went to theaters. But it wasn't bad. These leaning poses, in my opinion, are some of the hardest to do, because the angle's got to be just right or it doesn't feel right. I have reference for it off to the side there, but I'm not copying it. I don't want to copy it exactly, because it's not 100% necessarily what I want or what's going to fit with everything else, but I'm trying to use it to get myself started at least. Okay, let's try this again. Anybody else watch the live action Bebop? And if so, do we have thoughts? Okay. It's probably going to be a drawing show for me. I watch the anime at full attention, but I'll probably make the live action one a drawing show. But I will give it a shot. I have a friend that loves the anime, and he was actually pretty into the live action. Who are our favorite Bebop characters? But the Trigun reboot's still animated, right? It's not live action, or are they doing a live action one? By the way, I think Faye probably is my favorite character, actually. She's got kind of a cool, mysterious backstory and stuff. Which one's Millie? I've seen Trigun, but it's been a long time. In fact, the person it was someone loaned me the DVD set to watch it, and it's that person's birthday actually today, coincidentally. Happy birthday, Sarah, if you happen to be with us today. Can you describe her? The only one I'm remembering is there's the one that in the cape or whatever that had all the guns, like all the derringers or whatever it was. The only other character I'm really offhand remembering is the girl that had like the white outfit with all the derringers inside the cloak. But as I recall, she wasn't particularly big, so I'm assuming she's not who you're describing. can remember the Gatling gun, but I don't remember the person. Change this angle. Maybe I do. Hey, Parker, Parker, Parker. Have you seen Cowboy Bebop, Parker? Fuck, I gotta do him again. I like how he looks, but he's too low. I gotta draw him taller. He's gonna be stubby legs if I draw him there. Alright. Try this again. Third time's a charm. Is that because you only just got into it, or did you get distracted, or were you not feeling it? Alright, here we go. Using the full breadth of the paper here. Did I hear answers on favorite Bebop characters, by the way? I don't think anybody answered me on that. If they did, I missed it. And if so, I apologize, but feel free to repeat. Alright, music is pretty solid. I'll accept that. I got a trivia question for you, Billy. And I don't know the answer to this. I'm just wondering if you do. So you can tell there's a lot of North American influence on Cowboy Bebop. And I couldn't help but wonder if the dog named Ein was a reference to Back to the Future, where the dog's name is Einstein. Because they call Einstein Einy in Back to the Future. Do 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 do. All right, we got three down, two to go. Move my chair out of the way of my reference there for a minute. And you might be thinking, where am I gonna put Ed? Well, calm down, you'll find out right now. The intro, by the way, is maybe one of my favorite animated intros ever. Like, instantly became, probably. So if you only watched the first two characters, Van Parker, you barely met any of these characters. You would have met Spike and Jet. And does Faye show up in the second episode or the third? Actually, I think Ein's the first one to join the team, actually, isn't he? I just remembered something I wanted to do with Ed that I didn't grab reference for. To do that in a second. Thank you. actually using a real corgi for reference instead of Ein. Okay. So, probably is Einstein, but whether or not has any relation to Back to the Future, we don't know. Okay, I think we're ready to start doing some detail. I gotta grab one bit of reference I forgot to grab though. One sec here. To be wearing her goggles, but I need to see what those goggles look like. Oops. And away we go. I think my favorite episode, by the way, is when Spike realizes something that he left in the fridge is trying to kill everybody. especially when the reveal, and you never really quite see it. Is looking a little weird in my opinion, but I'm gonna leave them alone. Touch them up a bit more when I ink them. Character's already done. We're on a roll here, guys. And now let's do Faye. I think I did Ein in that drawing of Faye as well, if I remember. Like the ship itself, that will not be in this one, I'm afraid. I didn't mean to offend you that much, Billy. Sorry. Well, I'm gonna have to leave then if you're not drawing the Bebop. Crazy, the show is from 1998 as well. I don't know if I was at all aware of it back then. Well, I imagine, I mean, at least when it came out in Japan, I imagine it was a bit longer before it was available here. I guess so. For the reference of it there. Welcome back, Billy. How was your journey? Yeah, I just realized I can't actually see my own screen right now because I left Google Images up when I was searching for Ed's goggles. So if I ever push this thing off screen, guys, let me know. it's better than being eventful if the events are not good events, I guess, right? Right, there is Faye. Faye Valentine. It's a good film noir name. And now, Spike. Kinda, yeah. It's a double whammy. So if I hadn't canceled that one a couple weeks ago, I would have done Edge Runners a week sooner, and then I would have done this one this past Tuesday. But I didn't want to put it off any longer because I want to, assuming I'm happy with the end result, I want to include this in my my batch of prints for Fan Expo this year, and I want to get those off to the printer reasonably soon. So. So I decided I would fast track. Also, I recognized that this would be a longer one and thought this maybe wouldn't be such a bad one to do as a daytime stream. Because sometimes Tuesdays are fairly big work days, so by the time I actually get to the stream, I'm a little burnt out sometimes. So those 3-hour ones can be a bit of a crapshoot. Sometimes it's totally fine. Sometimes it's like, it's a lot, you know. So I figure let's take advantage of the situation, I guess. Or maybe not so much take advantage, but just find the silver lining in the situation. Hard to commit to them regularly, especially when we got other stuff on the go, but when they work out, not too bad. Can't believe how close Fan Expo actually is now. I just found out Peter Weller is going to be there, so I'm actually considering getting a... I'm collecting movie posters in my living room. I'm considering getting a RoboCop poster to get him to sign it. Sometimes they do cancel last minute. I am a little worried I'm going to do that. And then it'd be a cool poster anyway, but my main... What would have me most excited would be about it being signed. So it would definitely be a kink in the plan. Cool. Yeah, so Spike is done. Now we just got Jet. Should reverse which arm is in front here so we can see his. Speaking of RoboCop, am I right? My original plan was actually to exaggerate his robotic arm a lot more, but I guess I don't really have the page space for that exactly. May or may not be a test subject for what, Billy? What was I referring to? Aperture Sciences? I'm still missing something. Are you getting a robotic arm? A port? Oh. Take a lot of liberties with his arm here. Please don't hate me, Purus. But I want to. Okay, gotcha. I'm all caught up now. I'm picking up what you're putting down, smelling what you're stepping in. Crossing is always such a thing. Bagging what you're mowing. Okay, we're ready to start inking this thing. Give me 1 second here, guys. I'm gonna pop out for a minute. I'm still taking meds since the thing in my chest came back there last week, and I couldn't take them earlier because I got space. It's a whole thing. I'm gonna pop out for like 3 minutes. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Oops. I've had that screen actually for a while, that I'll be right back screen, but I don't have occasion to use it very often. I made that for the very first stream I ever did, actually. Where is my pen? Right there. Alright. Oh, wait. Well, let's see if it matters. Well, actually, I forgot. I was going to fix her foot. Let's do that. It's not bothering me quite as much as it was earlier, but... Now let's do it. Given Ed an almost jokery smile here. Thank you. I feel like I haven't watched enough anime to really have a favorite. And I think there's recency bias with Cowboy Bebop, having just watched it. But I honestly think it would probably rank pretty high for me. How about you guys? Well, Billy, I guess you haven't really watched much of it, you said, Parker. Tom said it was one of his favorites, although I'm not sure Tom's still with us at the moment. Actually, I think he said by the way, Tom is Bumper Cart, not the Tom from VFS, if anybody is watching from there and wondering. Got any fun Cowboy Bebop facts for us, Billy? super preoccupied, of course, don't worry about it. Phase cryogenic tube has a serial number NCC-1701B. Interesting. Is that a reference to anything? Oh shit, I should have recognized that actually. Yeah, NCC. As in the barks and stuff, I assume. Unless you mean like they rotoscoped them or something. I still think Ayn looks a little weird here, but I think once I color him with his patterning, I think he'll work. If not, I might need to do some surgery in Photoshop. Thank you. Okay. Actually, I don't know if I picked up. Is that clearly stated in the show, or is that more like the creator said that was the intent? Because I definitely didn't pick up that it was all simultaneously. If that was the case. I feel like Adult Swim, and then they probably showed it on Teletoon here, right? Maybe that's why I was aware of it. Even though I wasn't really following anime. Okay, the Ed person is done. For the moment, anyway, until we get to the spot blacks. Now for the Fae person. Do you think when the animators were working on Faye scenes, they referred to it as Anna Faye? I'll stop. Got Parker's attention with the pun. Puns to Parker are like shaving a haircut to Roger Rabbit. No tune can resist the old shave and a haircut. Okay. That's not too surprising, because he is kind of the main protagonist. Argument, like, it is kind of an ensemble show, but he is the only one that's in from beginning to end, pretty well, him and Jay, yes, but. Okay. I see what you did there, Parker. That's true, Billy. Very true. How about the first design comment? And it was a manga first, right? Or am I wrong about that? Oh, it wasn't anime first, okay. I noticed that all the episode titles are named after songs or types of music or dance, much like the word Bebop itself. I don't know. I don't know that one actually. Space. Oh, actually, I think I have heard of Space Dandy. Is Space Dandy the one that has that gif from it where the girl opens her shirt and like 1,000 boobs fly out? I feel like it is, but I'm not positive. I think I remember reading an article about Space Dandy. Thank you. Good seeing you too, Tom. Thanks for coming by. Hopefully, we'll see you again on here sometime. Something else I noticed while watching Bebop. For the most part, all the like the tones and like shadows and highlights in the characters are like fairly flat, kind of cel shaded style shadows like you would typically see on in most 2D animation. But for some reason, Faye's outfit is always like heavily rendered and stuff, like gradients and things. Well, I mean, I say for some reason. I think we probably all know what the reason is. They're wanting to add extra dimension to her shapes. But I still thought it was kind of funny and a little weird. I don't think that was necessary for what they were probably trying to do. I think it kind of works anyway. Nice. When are you hoping to do that, Parker? And you're going to completely change your banner, Parker? You're not going to be Arts of Darkness anymore? Welcome, welcome, Pilar. Where are you on the Cowboy Bebop fandom? Are you a fan? Yes, no, maybe so. Cool. And understood, Parker. Do you want to tell us what the new banner is? I only just recently watched it, Pilar, for the first time. For many years of it being recommended. Actually, I have seen Lupin the Third. I haven't seen it in a long time, though. I watched that when I was in school. Or are you talking about the newest one, actually? I'm thinking of the Miyazaki one. But they just did a 3D animated one recently, right? And there was a live action French TV show as well, which I heard was good. That Arts of Darkness made you come off as a internet personality or anything, Parker. I think it was a clever name, actually, for an artist banner. I think the live action is based on the same source material as the animated one, though. I think it was originally a French comic book, if I'm not mistaken, I think. Is One Piece your favorite anime, Blair? Can't remember if you said that or if I'm just assuming, because I know you got a lot of One Piece fan art and you're doing the zine. Right, okay. Oh, that's right, that's what it was, yeah. Yeah, it was like a French comic book, and then, but that was just Lupin, and then Lupin the Third was like the manga, continuation of it, right? And so this live action show is based on the original Lupin, not Lupin the Third. Doro Hidoro is my number one currently. I don't think I know that one. But I'm not an anime aficionado by any stretch either. I've heard of the name, but I've never watched it. But a lizard man, huh? Okay. I don't think you would need to know the game, Pillar. Like, and granted, I haven't watched the show, so I can't say. But the only thing that's really consistent in D&D is the world, like in the lore, which I assume the show would explain to you. But like every person who plays it with a different story. Like it's every experience with it is kind of unique. So I don't think you would need any pre-existing knowledge. As long as you like fantasy stuff, I think that's the only real prerequisite for anything D&D based. I myself have only played D&D like twice, I think, maybe three times. Yeah, and that looks good. I'm expecting a decent number of D&D fans to be in an uproar about it, though. The show looks like it has the movie looks like it has quite a bit of humor in it. And my experience with D&D includes a lot of joking around, so to me the vibe lines up. But some people would take it so seriously that nobody's allowed to make jokes during a D&D game. And those people, I don't think, would like the movie. There's the Fae person, so far. Spot blacks aside. I'm going to tweak his hair. I don't like how he did his hair. I'm going to pop it out the other side instead. Didn't look spike enough. There we go. That looks more spike-like. Spike-like. Yeah, I heard about that, Billy. I think they've backpedaled on that a little bit, haven't they? Because of the backlash. But some people say it's too little too late because it just shows how they feel about the community or whatever. Is D&D also Wizards of the Coast? Am I right? Because they've also been getting shit for how they've been handling Magic the Gathering, I've heard. How long has Hasbro owned them? Is that a recent buyout, or they owned them for a long time? Okay, so been a while. If it was a recent buyout, I would be inclined to say, oh, it's clearly why is this all happening, but mostly only know what Philly D was talking about on YouTube, and then Cam talked a little bit about it at Laurie's birthday a few weeks ago. Cam is a mutual friend of me and Parker's, and plays in not so much recently, but used to play in Magic tournaments quite a bit. Yeah, definitely. Well, with the magic thing, it was kind of like they were coming up with new shit so much that it was almost impossible to keep up with, from what I understand. I'm not a magic player myself. Too is it probably was consistently making a profit or wouldn't have lasted this long in the first place. So it's just them being like, but we could do more, and then shoot themselves in the foot. Kind of similar to what happened with comics in the 90s, right? They had the speculator boom, and everybody and their dog started collecting comics, thinking it was this big investment. And then the publishers cashed in on it so much that they were producing more than they could sell. And then it all imploded on them. happened with Catan, well, because Catan kept coming out with the expansions and stuff. Except with Catan, you're not as reliant on that stuff to keep up with it, right? Or not necessarily. I guess it depends on how serious you are about it. But that is definitely a thing, player. Like, I've only played D&D, like I said, 2, maybe 3 times. And I had fun with it, but it was like, every time, they were far enough apart that I was kind of learning the rules from scratch each time. And you're kind of just barely starting to enjoy it, and then the game's over. So it's intimidating to start fresh. Yeah. And then that intimidation keeps you away from it in the first place. Yeah, no, there's a lot to be said for simplicity. I agree. Oh, yeah. That I don't know if I ever really did that pillar, but I'm definitely the type to do that, because I would appreciate the art on the cards. But I never really got into any of the game ones. I think like if someone had gifted me a pack of Magic cards when I was a kid, I think it might have started something, because the artwork in those are so cool. But that just never really happened. But I was really into, like, and these weren't a game, but I was really into these, like, Marvel and X-Men trading cards for a while, which I still have in a Jersey Milk tin in my closet to this day. The infamous Jersey Milk stocking stuffer from, I want to say, probably 1994, 1995, somewhere around there. It was a metal tin filled with miniature Jersey Milk chocolate bars. And on Christmas Day, my mom had, like, baked so much that I didn't get into them at all that day. And then the next morning, I woke up and they were all gone because my dad had eaten them all. And I still bring it up and give him shit for it every once in a while. Secret Hitler's fun. I've played that. I haven't played the other ones, though. I was playing some games with some friends yesterday. We played, Dead of Winter is probably the most intense, like, RPG board game I've ever played. Takes a while to get into it every time. My only thing with those types of games sometimes, I think they're fun, but each person's turn can take like a really freaking long time sometimes. And that it makes it hard not to check out, I feel like, on occasion. Secret Hitler's pretty fun. Something you can check out when you're here, Pilar, especially once you're actually here for school and you with your classmates, there's a few places around that actually have a lot of these games, like a restaurant. You go in, eat, and play a board game. There's a pizza place. There's actually one in New West really close to me, but there's also one pretty close to the school downtown called Ludica. And there's a new one that just opened up that I haven't been into. It's really close to the writing campus. And it's it looks like almost like a coffee shop with like baked goods and stuff, but it's also like board games and things to play. Monopoly is fun, Parker, but it's also a recipe for disaster. And chilies. I don't know. Or is that what Billy is saying is like trouble? All right, sounds good. Getting itchy again. I can't wait till it's just like normal skin there again that just happens to look different. Hey, Chantal. Bonus stream. Making up for skipping one a couple weeks ago, and also I wanted to get this one done in time to get prints for Fan Expo this year. Fan Expo is mid-February, so I don't want to leave the stuff to the last minute, which I occasionally have done in the past, and then it's like stressful if I'm going to get my prints in time. How are you doing, Chantal? Okay, Pilar. Nice talking to you as usual. See you next time. Itchy does mean it's healing, yes. Or Parcheesi. Okay, I've never played it. I have heard of that, though. What is a Sunday shift like at Walmart, Chantel? Is it chill? Is it intense? Is it a raucous good time? Sorry, I don't remember Trouble too well. Like, I know which is it. Trouble's the one with the bubble in the middle, right? It's fun getting into Trouble. Are you a Cowboy Bebop fan at all, Chantel? For the win. I'm in trouble. Okay. I just watched it recently and quite enjoyed it. So, okay, remind me of the rules then of both sorry and or trouble, Billy, because like I said, I don't remember trouble well enough, but I don't necessarily remember thinking of them as this, but I know I played it, and I don't remember them feeling like the same game necessarily. Maybe that's a big ass to ask you to type out all the instructions for sorry, by the way, Billy. You don't have to do it. Just so we're clear. Or you already did. Okay, you start out with pegs in starting area. You move out. You need to roll a six. You win when all pegs are in the ending area of the same color. If another player peg lands on yours, it returns to the starting area. Okay, I remember that. And that's when you yell out, sorry. So in the case of trouble, though, where does the bubble come into play? You know a game I had as a kid that always annoyed everybody involved? And I was talking about this recently in class with Pasha in particular. I don't know if any of you guys know Pasha, but Dizzy Dizzy Dinosaur. Share the commercial for Dizzy Dizzy Dinosaur. Do you remember Dizzy Dizzy Dinosaur, Chantel? Because we're close in age. It was about, it's like, there's like a dinosaur, Dizzy Dizzy Dinosaur. And it's like a wind-up thing, and then at some point you're supposed to wind it up and like let it go on the board, and then hope that he doesn't knock your thing off the board. But the but he would always get caught in the seam of the board, like where it folds. So we never really worked the way you're supposed to. So my parents, especially my mom, like hated this fucking game. I was so excited to get it for my birthday or for Christmas, whatever it was that year, and they were excited to give it to me, and then it was such a freaking pain in the ass to play. I don't think it really lasted, which is kind of why I zeroed in on you there, Chantel, because I think if you weren't aware of it in the moment, it didn't last very long. So if you're just like a couple of years apart, it might not stick. Okay, Chantel. Have a good rest of your shift. Okay. Huge fan of Jet's beard. I don't know what it is. I feel like so many animes have characters with this exact beard thing. Kind of annoys me a little bit. I don't know why. I mean, his is a bit more distinctive because it's so pointy, I guess, but. It's like, it always has to be that one goatee character. Mutton chop character. Some wrinkles in the guy's forehead. You can't be that bald and not have wrinkles on the forehead. Ink. if you were going to replace a body part with something cybernetic, what would it be? And remember, you are live on the internet right now. There you go. Billy's got you covered. And it can be only one. So you can't replace both your legs. It would have to just be a single leg. Just keep that in mind if that changes anything. Nope. But one eye. Which one? Would it shoot lasers and stuff too? And you would replace your eye, Parker? Would yours shoot lasers and stuff? By the way, speaking of laser eyes, unrelated, but I finally watched the new Mortal Kombat movie the other day. You guys seen it? I enjoyed it, but I had some things I didn't love. His knee pads don't have these holes in them, but they do now. Okay, fair enough, fair enough. Oh, you also just watched Mortal Kombat, Parker? What'd you think? Yeah, I would agree. I thought that, like, overall, character development was probably better, effects were better, the gritty approach to it felt a little bit better. Like, I would say in a lot of ways it was a stronger script, but then we also never really get the tournament, which is kind of the whole point of Mortal Kombat, so that felt like a major overlook. And I thought it was really weird that they created a brand new character for the protagonist instead of using somebody from the game. Like, that character could have easily been Luke Cage, or Johnny Cage, rather. Because, like, they made him a relative to Scorpion, but he didn't need to be to make sense. And he was kind of a boring character. And by the way, that's not really a spoiler. It's made pretty clear pretty early on. I haven't seen the 95 version in a really long time, though, in fairness, so there could be a little bit of nostalgia playing tricks on me there as well. Because I probably haven't seen it since 1995. Yeah, I liked Kano in that one a lot. I didn't even remember Kano in the original one. I had to look him up. But I liked he was maybe my favorite part in the new one, honestly. Okay, Parker, have a good one. Time for the spot blacks. We are almost done here, folks. 3 hours is what I had originally estimated for this one. And then for a minute, I thought maybe I was going to do it in less. Looks like we're going to do it a little over, but probably not much. So here we go. Home stretch. once again, Billy, I read your bye as Snake from The Simpsons. Bye. Yeah, I've been hearing great things about it. There's a guy in my class right now that's already seen it like 7 times, I think he said. Getting in the zone here a little bit. I'm not like barely talking anymore. Okay, favorite sci-fi western, go. Yeah, probably mine too. Fairness, I can't think of too many other. There's, I mean, Star Wars technically, I guess. Especially Mandalorian. Thank you. think I may have just asked an impossible question. Do you know if there's a story behind, and without spoilers for anybody who hasn't watched, I was surprised at how definitive the ending of Bebop was. And then I'm even more surprised now to hear it was created as an anime. Like, was there at any point thought that it would go longer than it did, and then it wasn't going to happen, so they tied things up, or... was it always intended to be as short as it was? Oh, really? Okay. And then which would have had a shorter runtime, I guess, anyway. So did the movie storyline get stretched out into 26 episodes, or was the movie storyline the movie they ended up making later? I did notice that. It was fairly episodic. Okay. Last round here. Okay, the Ed person is done, okay? And the Fey person is done, okay. Thank you. And the spike person is done okay. Okay, and the jet per- oh, no, wait, take it back, hang on, that was close. Holy shit, that was close. There we go. And the jet person is done, okay. Alright, let's throw us the intro on there, we're gonna call it done. Actually, hang on a second, you get more crotch wrinkle, there we go. Let's do it over here. Thank you, Billy. So there we go. There's Cowboy Bebop. I'm going to color this afternoon. Not on stream for the coloring this go around. But I'm going to color it pretty soon. I might even post it just as soon. We'll see. But in the meantime, thanks for watching. Same time as usual next week. My Tuesdays and Thursdays, 8:30. All that good stuff. So thanks for watching. Those of you that are still with us. And I'll see you next time. Have a good one.